to say to the people of New Orleans?
Yes, indeed. Mardi Gras. All right.
Keep smiling. We love you. When's your album going to come out?
About 2 months, probably.
Any idea what the title's going to be?
Not yet, but stick around and we'll let you know.
But Venus and Mars are all right tonight.
This is just a little hint. Love is blind. Well, I don't know, but I say
love is kind. We're getting around a bit in those days.
You know, we went to Lagos because of African music, went to Nashville because it was America, and, you know, the New Orleans scene, the sort of R&B thing there is great. Even though you didn't use the style of the town you were in too much, it still influenced the way you felt.
Shall we dance?
So Joe would probably drum a bit funkier than if he was in Lancashire. We took a couple of days off and had Mardi Gras.
Got dressed up.
Dressed up as clowns, thinking no one will recognise us at all. And people in the street, hi, Paul. I said, no, I'm a clown. Mm. Hey, Paul.
It was fantastic, really, because we'd come from very small beginnings after the hugeness of the Beatles. We'd put together this new band, actually making records that people really liked, number one records. We'd wanted to start something up just to continue playing music. Then we'd wanted it to be something cool that was us, allowed us to be free and experiment. Then we wanted to practice it and get a really good group. So we finally had done all of those things. And now, here we were, like, poised to actually take it out and show off a bit. So, on September the 9th, we kicked off the world tour at the Gaumont Theatre, Southampton, England.
Sitting in the stand at the sparkling waiting for the show to begin. Red lights, green lights, strawberry wine. Good friend of mine follows the stars. Venus and Mars are all right tonight.
Took us all across the other side of the world to Australia. Was that a difficult decision to make?
The only people it was an issue to were newspaper people. So, oh, look at those dreadful rock and roll people doing that, you know. It was not like you were hanging around all night and everyone was out on acid or out on coke or totally out of it. There were parties and stuff, but they were a bit more like family parties.
We always had to go to bed. I remember wanting
to
stay up and being ushered into either not being there and being back sleeping, or be like going into a bedroom and having to go to sleep and be like, we want to stay up.
That's kids, though. That's what kids always want to stay up, and they always have to go to bed. We managed one way or another to combine being in a rock and roll band and bringing up a family.
Any problems with security these days for your children and your wife?
No, I don't think so. You know, we don't worry too much about it, but we've got a fellow working with us in the world called Billy.
Billy!
He's about 10 foot tall and he's got a...
Heart of gold.
Heart of gold, yeah.
Rolling up.
carrot.
It's going to see the horses.
Yeah.
You want to tag along?
This is the wing carrot.
Everybody tag.
Mother and wife is it for me. And then riding my horse and my animals is it to me. And photography is part of that.
This is called a prickly pear cacti. You find those in Arizona as well.
I wasn't very good at school. In school, see that?
Notice the wildflowers at this beautiful place where we're staying.
But I think pretty much if you get an experience in life,
after you lads,
understand people more than what you learn in school.
This one's in, gonna have a baby.
Any day now.
I mean, Heather is very worldly, just having come with us everywhere we've gone.
Sure, we should have got some bread.
Oh, come on, little girl.
McCartney has just been told that a planned tour of Japan, scheduled to follow his Australian tour, had just been cancelled because of a conviction in Britain for possessing cannabis.
How do you feel about being kept out of Japan, Paul?
Oh, it's a bit tough, you know. It's a pity, because we were ready to go and everything.
Hello, people of Japan. This is Paul McCartney of Wings, saying that we're very sorry that we can't come to Japan to play our music to you this time, but if the Minister of Justice says we can't come in, then we can't come in. So we'll see you next time. Don't worry, we'll see you when we come back to your beautiful country. Sayonara. And in fact, rock on. Great tour. All the news people go, oh, McCartney's back in town with Wings.
6 years after the Beatles broke up, Paul McCartney was coming back as one of the few 60s superstars still alive, still making music and money, still a superstar.
McCartney is the most successful former Beatle. He's had 6 gold records, and it's estimated that this tour will take in over $5 million.
And by the time we got to Seattle, we've got the world attendance record.
Flying high, Paul McCartney is a superstar the second time around.
He is sold out for 3 nights, bringing in over $500,000 on the strength of Paul McCartney and Wings. It is his show and his money.
Exciting. It's like you've had a lot of parties in little places, and now you're going to have a party in a whacking great place.
The more people who see the show, the better. I really like the stadiums. I find them very intimate. I know most people don't. I don't really want to go back to the little ones.
The concert began in the dark, and smoke machines filled the stage with fog. At 8:25, the lights came up, and there he was.
chance maybe John would show up.
McCartney insists the Beatles are dead. Long live Wings.
Maybe here, maybe tonight. So far, no Beatle bulletins. Will it happen tomorrow night?
It's a probably no-no.
You know, I'm bound to ask about that multi-million-dollar offer to reform the Beatles.
We don't know, but we will be there to find out.
Just perhaps all four Beatles may show up on the stage here.
The Beatles split in 69, and since then, they've been doing fine. And if that question doesn't cease, ain't no one gonna get no peace. And if you ask it just once more, I think I'm gonna break your jaw. This was a little ditty that I made up, Muhammad Ali style, in order to answer the inevitable question I was getting asked at that time, which was, when are the Beatles gonna get back together? When are the Beatles gonna get back together? There were one or two little hiccups, because Jimmy was his own man, shall we say. There was one incident when he didn't want to come back on for the encore. And so I was like, what? I mean, I've never had anyone decide that ever before. So I sort of just ran off. So grabbed him, said, you're coming back on. And he responded well to that bit of direction. He came on, he played a blinder. And the word spread that, like, this was a good show.
Mm.
Never mind the Beatles. This is like a good show to go and see. There's something completely different.
How did it feel to, like, turn and see Mum by your side?
It was great.
Yeah.
It was really great, yeah. Beautiful. It was great for me. It was kind of the payoff. You know, that was the crazy idea we'd started in the beginning. What if you're up on stage with me?
Mm.
And even though it seemed like totally impossible, there it was happening.
This tour has been so much fun, especially on stage. Right, honey?
Right, honey.
She's enjoying being in the band. Doing all the harmonies, doing the keyboards. She's confident, and we were having a good time. She's kind of answered all her critics.
Mm.
That's all gone away, you know. People are now saying, wow, you know, this is just a good band. Which is really the point we'd wanted to get to.
Right now, I'm speaking to you from a backstage phone. After a sellout performance that had the 20,000 and plus McCartney fans on their feet, no John Lennon, no George Harrison, and no Ringo Starr, just Paul McCartney and Wings. For everyone here tonight, that seemed to be plenty.